I honestly do. I think it's a shame, but I mean, I can't speak on who done it and who did it and what for, why, what happened. A lot of crazy things happen in the neighborhood.
Tonight, an Eastside Kansas City neighborhood is shaken up after 6 murders in less than 12 hours. That's first at 10. One father says he wants to see some major changes in the neighborhood for the sake of his 3 kids. Good evening, everyone. I'm Rob Lowe.
And I'm Mary Pulley. Fox 4's Gia Vang is live at police headquarters in downtown to tell us more. Gia?
Well, Mary and Rob, right now the city's homicide count is at 95, all because of what's unfolded in the past 2 days. Now, as one father who lives close to those deadly incidents speaking out. The Marchbanks kids throw the football around under the careful watch of their father. Cameron Marchbanks says he gets worried about letting them do it alone in this Eastside neighborhood.
There's been a lot of stuff going on, shooting. You hear a lot of shooting stuff around the neighborhood.
And in just the last 24 hours, it's been more so than usual. Kansas City police say they found 3 people shot in a house off Lister. Then early Saturday morning, a double shooting at a house on Benton. Rounding out the 6 killed, a suspected arson within blocks of one of the shootings claimed the life of one more. Police are expected to have 20% more patrols out after these deadly incidents, but that's not enough for one neighbor.
I've been staying here for basically almost all my life, and ain't nothing really gonna change. Nothing's really gonna change.
Police Chief Daryl Forte seems to think otherwise. He wants to boost community policing and says it will make a difference in the long run.
In one of the locations, people heard gunshots this morning. They heard what they thought, somebody falling. But you know what? Nobody opened the door to look out.
And for the future of his 3 kids, Marchbanks hopes his neighbors will do that.
I'd like to see, you know, more family stuff going on around the neighborhood, cleaning up the houses and people looking out for the neighbors.
And the police chief did tell us that the extra officers out tonight patrolling are patrolling more than just those what they call the hotspot areas. Gia Vang, Fox 4 News, working for you live in Kansas City, Missouri.
Okay, thank you so much, Gia. Kansas City Mayor Sly James says despite the deadly 2 days, it's still too early to judge the new police chief's plan to curb violence.
They cannot be expected to realistically yield a 180-degree turnaround in the situation that's existed in this city for years, but we're doing the best that we can.
At a news conference, the mayor said the city is in its initial steps with Chief Daryl Forte, who has been on the post only for about a month. The mayor says the issue of violence remains Kansas City's top priority.